All righty. Yeah, Philly versus Denver coming up in just about a minute now. Let's run through the rosters really quick. I'll go ahead and take Philly here for you. We've got number 0, Meryl Stripper. Number 6, Michelle Castro. Number 15, Kill Martin. Number 1, 5-2, Herman Monster. Number 18, V-Diva Vanessa Seitz. Number 247, Devoid of Mercy. Number 33, Legend of the Hit and Trample. Number 401, Tarantula. Number 7, Clam Jammer. Number 80, Papa Roach. Number 85, Teflon Donna. Number 9, Deb Seriously. Number 957, Gingivitis. Number 99, Russian Bayou.
Garden. Number 4, Busick. Number 52, Dagallo. Number 719, Sharpless. Number 75, DJ Oli. Number 8,
we'll run through the lineups here. We're going to start with the action.
Alrighty, up to jam first. Number 18, V Diva versus number 4, Jersey Justice. Busick up at the front of the pack there. Takes a little bit of spill, but recovers quickly. She's out and eligible to score as well now. And Busick not lead jammer, so 5 on the board. She's got 30 seconds to rack up some points for Denver before VD will return to the track. Pack waits for Busick to come back around. Slow roll going on right now. And Busick back in for another scoring pass of her own. She's on the outside line. She is out and around. Another 5 on the board. And Busick is loving this. She's through.
Queso and Kerr.
Alrighty, and
big props to our host, Emerald City. We headed to jam number 2. Jam host for Denver. As the break stands, 20, Wilhelm.
And Wilhelm out of the pack, lead jammer for Denver. Wilhelm through for 5 for the Mile High Club. She's going to keep going for some score because V-Diva on her initial pass. V-Diva having some trouble getting out there. Taken to the outside line by S.H. Long and Quigley.
Looks like
And another four-point pass for Wilhelm. V. Diva, meanwhile, still fighting against that wall. And I apologize at home. Joe Mama is announcing with me, but I think we're having some mic trouble, so you may not be hearing what he's saying. I hope you are. As we get started here, it is number 719, Sharpless, jamming for the Mile High Club, and number 15, Kill Martin, for Philly. And Sharpless almost makes her way out. She gets swallowed back up by the pack, and now she's going to have to start that trip all the way through as she was taken to the outfield. Kill Martin in on a scoring pass.
Sharpless with the star for Denver.
Okay, looks like I'm on the microphone now. Sorry about that. A little technical difficulties. 5 points there to Kill Martin for Philadelphia.
Yeah, we apologize to you at home if you were only getting half of the conversation that Joe and I were having.
I was trying to talk loud.
Kill Martin recycled by to the outside and all the way back. And up in the front, it looks like the star has been handed to Akers. She is out and free.
Good kill, though, by the Mile High Club, holding Philly to only 9 points total. That will take Philadelphia to score a 13. Denver 38, 24 minutes and 20 seconds left in this first half of play. I want to thank Sin City Skates. Over 25 combined years of on-track derby experience, SinCitySkates.com, where customer service is the name of our game. Sin City Skates. Looks like jamming now for the Mile High Club. That is number 36, DeZellum.
And for Philly, number 152, Herman Monster. Number 99 getting a penalty. That's Russian Bayou.
Oh, penalty assessed to DeZellum. So power jam Philadelphia. Herman Monster out there by her lonesome. Philly now dropping back and picking up a failure to reform penalty is number 80, Papa Roach. And now a back block call on the jammer from Philadelphia. Herman Monster will sit and DeZellum will pop up.
No lead jammer, so we'll go for the full length of the jam. We've got about a minute 13 remaining on the clock as DeZellum comes in on her initial pass. She's all the way through, eligible to score. I see Herman Monster coming back onto the track from the penalty box.
Denver now holding, and DeZellum finds an inside line through. 4 points for Denver. Herman Monster now out, one to beat. That's Lorch, and she is through, picking up 5 points there on that pass for Philadelphia.
DeZellum now all the way back, hitting the backside of that pack, looking to go to the outside, driven out. Going to recycle as Herman Monster at the front side of the pack there, all the way through for another four.
Looks like Lorch picking up a penalty for Denver. She'll head to the box. DeZellum now three to beat. Very tough three up front from Philadelphia. Good bridge by number 401, Tarantula. As Herman Monster hits the pack, that's Quigley and Angeli. And she is through. That's another 5 points for Philly. Philly now brings their score up to 27. Cut track penalty now called on Ginger Vitus for Philadelphia. Four more points there for Denver. That'll take our score to Denver 46. Another 3 points for Philadelphia. That takes their score to 30. 21 minutes and 45 seconds left in this first period of play. Last time these two teams met, WFTDA Championships in 2014, on Halloween Day, Denver Roller Derby victorious, but only by 9 points. Denver Roller Dolls at that time, 148, Philadelia, 139.
Number four, Busick, jamming for the Mile High Club. Number seven, Clam Jammer for the Liberty Bells. Busick already out and Lee Jammer. Meanwhile, number 129, Salvador, hanging up Clam Jammer there, but Clam Jammer able to find her way free of the pack.
Busick through for a quick four, calls the jam, takes Denver's score to 50, Philadelphia 30, 20 minutes and 55 seconds left in this first period of play.
Ninkasi Brewing, the official beer of Emerald City Roller Girls. Check them out.
I have. They're delicious. They're Dawn of the Red.
I may go have to try that myself tonight.
You need to. There's a wonderful ramen place that has all of their stuff around here. Oh, you went there.
I've gone to the ramen place. I haven't tried any of the brews yet.
So, wonderful town. People here in Eugene, great tournament. Super excited. Jamming now for Denver. That's Wilhelm through Lee Jammer. V-Diva jamming for Philadelphia. Philly now has their full pack in play, forming a wall up at turn one.
Wilhelm all the way back around the scoring passes. V-Diva taking to the infield is going to recycle. Lorch, number 1911, headed off to the penalty box, puts Denver down a blocker in the pack. Wilhelm kind of stuck in the pack there, still looking for a way through as V-Diva coming around to score.
Good block there by S.H. Long. V-Diva, no points, five full points on the board for Wilhelm. That'll take the score of Denver 55, Philadelphia 30, 19 minutes and 45 seconds left in this first period of play. Gotta have a little fun. Here at the Big O. It's been an amazing tournament thus far, hasn't it, Smash?
It absolutely has been. And you can join in on all the amazingness. Hashtag Big O 2015.
Hash brown.
Hash brown.
Delicious.
Talk to us. We'll shout out for you if we check it while we're up here and all this action going on.
All right, jamming for the Mile High Club, number 719, Sharpless, up against number 15 for Philadelphia, Kill Martin. Good wall up front by Philadelphia, and nice wall at the rear, but picking up a multiplayer box penalty is number 99, Acres. Forearm penalty on Sharpless. Kill Martin, one to beat, and she's through Lee Jammer, Philadelphia. Denver hemorrhaging blockers.
And Kill Martin calling off the jam there, and then she looked up and she noticed that Sharpless was not out of the pack. She was going to the box. And so she called off the jam, but she didn't mean to at that point in time. It looked like she had a little bit of remorse after calling off that jam.
We'll never know since we can't read minds. Thank God I can't do that. That would be horrible.
It would be pretty bad.
Score still stands. Denver 55, Philadelphia 30, 18 minutes and 25 seconds left. So Jammer there by her lonesome. That is number 152 for Philadelphia, Herman Monster. And out of play called on Quigley. And now out of play also called on Barrett. One blocker out there for the Mile High Club. Full compliment for the Liberty Bells. Herman Monster signaling for some offense. Now pack is in the front. No pack and a pass. And there should be, there are 5 points total called for Philadelphia.
Mile High Club getting some blockers back from the penalty box. S.H. Long waiting for Herman Monster. Multiplayer block called on
Gingivitis for Philadelphia. And Herman Monster threw 4 points there on that pass. Sharpless still stuck in the pack. Now getting recycled all the way to turn four.
And Herman Monster coming back in, gets hung up by S.H. Long and Quigley with some help at the front side of that wall by Akers.
Akers now receives the star. Actually, did not. A little feint of a pass, and Sharpless through with a cap in hand. Herman Monster calls the jam. Full 5 points on the board for Philadelphia. Moving further and further up the board. Philly with 44, Denver 55, 16 minutes and 50 seconds left in this first period.
11-point game as we get an official review called by the coach for Mile High. Once we find out what it's about, if we find out what it's about, we'll let you know.
I hope we will. And also hope I get a better look at those overalls that Coach Scott Free is sporting. The overalls, truly a step one better than the jort.
I completely agree. I completely agree.
It's the extra material, I think, which makes it a level up, in my opinion. If we want to use that terminology.
The extra material.
So great work by Philly, managing to pull cuts on the Denver blockers and other penalties, taking full advantage of the smaller packs as well as the jammer penalties for Denver. That was something that plagued Denver yesterday against Texas, was the amount of jammer penalties.
It did, and then in the second half, Denver fixed things. So hopefully with this review, they're able to get together, talk about what's going on, and address those situations that are happening out there on the track.
This is true, but they are still in the lead right now with 17 minutes and 9 seconds. Score Denver 55, Philly 44. If you're joining us on WFTDA.tv, Denver in the blue, Philadelphia in the white. We just need Angel City out here and America.
And America. Well, Texas is here, and they have the red and white jerseys, so that might work for you.
It's not enough red.
Eh.
Atlanta has a good red.
Atlanta
Angel
does have
City
a good
has a good red. And now we're on TV. I know. So we're still going through the official review. Again, Philly and Denver have met numerous times, but as the years go by, rosters change. Updates are made, strategies are conferred, and we'll see what's happening. Looks like Sir Osis will be taking the microphone.
Alrighty, Joe Mama looking to hear what that review was about.
For points, Lachlan. Everything stands as it was called.
Looks like it was just a points issue from the Denver side, and what Cirrosis said, that nothing changed, but the review was retained. Maybe it was just a clarification. Oh, so the review is not retained for this half.
Alrighty, so back into the action on the track. It's number 36, DeZellum, jamming for Denver. Number 7, Clam Jammer, right behind her. DeZellum, the first out, lead jammer. They are racing for the pack. DeZellum looking for some points. Can she get him without giving up any? She calls off the jam. 2-4 Denver, 1-4 Philly. So a 1-point gain for Denver on the pass.
Well, there you go. Denver 57, Philly 47. 16 minutes and 30 seconds left. I want to thank Notorious R.E.D. Notorious Gear Deodorant by Notorious R.E.D. Smell clean even if you play dirty. Go to NotoriousRED.com.
Already lined up for Denver, number 4, Jersey. I'm going back to the old names here. Number 4, Busick, 4 mile high.
Busick on the inside through lead jammer Denver. Number 15 jamming for Philadelphia. It's Kilmartin still stuck behind pack, but Angeli headed to the box for Denver. One to beat S.H. Long, and she is through for Philadelphia. Busick now looking for some offense from Quigley, finds a hole and calls the jam though. See any points she picked up? 2 points for Denver, no points for Philadelphia. Takes our score to Denver 59, Philly 45. So again, I can't say enough about the city of Eugene and the wonderful hosts that Emerald City Roller Girls have been here at the Big O. My first Big O experience, Smash, how about you?
My first too, my first actually coming to Oregon.
Imagine all the oxygen.
And it's so, know, nice here,
having
it's so
come
green.
From the Colorado area that we have here.
And I could breathe like actual oxygen today. Back to the action on the track. It is Wilhelm, number 20, 4 mile high club. At the front of the pack, she is out. Lead jammer, number 18, V Diva 4 Philly, also makes her way around the 2 mile high blockers at the front of the pack, out to score. Wilhelm gets hung up in the pack. V Diva able to go right through for 4, so matching 4 for 4 on the pass there.
Angeli rejoins the pack for Denver, so now 4 on 4 as V Diva skirts the outside. Wilhelm calls the jam. Let's see if she picked. No points for her on that pass. Let's see if any points were picked up by V Diva. Looks like the jam ref for Philly right now is conferring 2 points there for V Diva. We'll take their score to 51, Denver 63, 14 minutes and 13 seconds left in this first period of play. Jamming now for Philadelphia, that is number 152, Herman Monster. It looks like jamming for Denver is number 36, DeZellum.
DeZellum knocked to the outside, gonna have to recycle. She watched her feet there, did not want to step in too early.
Everyone skate in the clockwise direction as blockers were recycling the jammer. Nice work there by DeZellum, but runs into the wall of number 80. That's Papa Roach for Philly. Papa Roach now bridging the pack. And Tarantula now with gingivitis working on DeZellum, trying to push her out, and they are successful recycling her to the back all the way to turn one.
Meanwhile, back in the back, or what used to be the back of the pack, Herman Monster really working on that Denver wall, but the Denver wall just really not giving her anything. And now Denver up front stretching out. She's got SH Long and Lorch to go as she continues to drive it.
Pack now spread up all the way between turns two and turn one. DeZellum working hard on that wall of white at the rear. Still no lead jammer call, and we are 1 minute and 15 seconds into the jam.
And SH Long able to take out Herman Monster and send her all the way back. And again, SH Long waiting for Herman Monster.
DeZellum took off the cap and now recycled to the back of turn two by Tarantula. Now back in the fray with Philadelphia. All blockers on the pack and all blockers making life miserable. Cap was passed there to Quigley by DeZellum. And lead call to Herman Monster. She calls the jam before Quigley puts any points on the board. So almost 2 minutes of no scoring and very, very tough defense by both teams. Their score will stand Denver 63, Philadelphia 51.
That was some amazing gameplay happening there.
Good defense.
The blockers just really bringing it on.
Very good defense by both squads.
Already
controlled and tough.
You're absolutely right. Next up, we've got number 15, Kill Martin, versus number 4, Busick, on the line.
Philly had the back wall. Denver had the front. Now reverse positions as Busick runs, and she is through. Skirts two big blocks from Teflon Donna and Devoid of Mercy, and is lead jammer for Denver.
Kill Martin getting stuck there in the mile high wall.
Busick now with two to beat and some offense there up front by Akers. Dalgallo, Salvador, and Lester are working on Kilmartin at the rear of the pack. And Busick through lead jam. Oh, sorry, that's 5 points on the board for Denver.
Meanwhile, Kilmartin recycled back after a takeout by Dalgallo and Lester. Akers taking her all the way back. Busick again through for another five.
Meryl Stripper has the cap now as it was passed, and looks like a low block penalty now assessed to Lester. And now a penalty assessed to Dalgallo. Akers now standing in place. Busick another 5 points on the board for Denver.
Now Salvador laying on Kill Martin. I'm sorry, that's the change. Meryl Stripper and Tracy Akers at the front now. Last one to beat for Meryl Stripper. Meryl Stripper finds her way out.
Oh, look, a high block call on Meryl Stripper. Power jam for the Mile High Club. And it was their pivot come jammer now in the box for Philadelphia. Another 5 points on the board for Denver.
And now Busick unopposed is going to be looking to continue to increase that point spread.
Good offense there up front by Lester as the jam is called. 5 more points on the board for Denver. Big jam, Denver 88, Philadelphia 51. 9 minutes and 40 seconds left. First period of play. Want to thank Rydell Skates. Rydell Skates, unmatched quality, unmatched performance. Rydell Skates.
minutes, 20 seconds to go in this first period.
All right, so we're going to start with Wilhelm, number 24, Mile High Club, on the track unopposed. Looking to gain lead.
Meryl Stripper, though, for Philadelphia, standing up in the box. Denver awaiting right at the pivot line. Nice bridge there by number 401 Tarantula for Philadelphia. And through lead jammer Wilhelm, number 99, sent to the box, Russian Bayou for Philadelphia. And a high block called now on Meryl Stripper. So we have another power jam. Wilhelm threw another 5 points for the Mile High Club.
Meryl Stripper going to pass the helmet cover to V Diva. Unfortunately made impact, and that cost her not being able to pass the helmet cover and the penalty.
Wilhelm threw another 5 points. A little 2009 strategy as the Mile High Club, goat number 957 Ginger Vitus at the rear of the pack as Wilhelm pushes that pack of Tarantula and V Diva forward. Round the shoehorn, another 5 points for Wilhelm. And she calls the jam, effectively freezing Meryl Stripper on the track. What do you think about that strategy, Smash?
You know, that's proven to be a good strategy for Denver. The last jam, Meryl Stripper came back in, picked up a penalty almost immediately. Maybe Denver hoping that the same thing will happen. She's standing in the box. She's likely going to come in and try to pass that helmet cover to V Diva, just like she just tried to do. And if Denver's in the way and can get that penalty called again, they got another power jam coming.
Again, I think it's savvy given that a pivot's not a typical jammer. So when you've passed the star and there's a penalty, why not leave the pivot, freeze the pivot as much as you can on the track? Sharpless through, beats Teflon Donna, lead jammer Denver. And now we have a star pass, attempted star pass, Meryl Stripper to V Diva.
And Meryl Stripper keeping her arms down low. V Diva now has the helmet cover around Lester on the outside and putting on the star.
Sharpless now in the pack, putting points on the board for Denver, looking for some offense. Calls the jam before V Diva can come in. 3 points on the board for Denver, but luckily for Philadelphia, they were able to free their jammer. Now they'll have a fresh jammer on the line for the next jam. Score now, Denver 106, Philadelphia 51. Diva retains the star, will jam for Philadelphia up against number 4, Busick for Denver.
There's the whistle. Both jammers with a slow start off the line, assessing where the walls are, looking for a hole. V Diva taken out by Quigley. Has to recycle. Busick at the front with just two to beat.
Tarantula almost gets her on the outside, but she's through. Lead jammer Busick. V Diva now working on that wall of Lorch and Lester. Long now joining the fray, and just the cue by herself, Quigley bridging the gap.
Busick all the way around, has a little trouble at the outside to start with, but then finds that outside line. 5 points on the board for Mile High.
Looks like penalty now assessed to Lorch for Denver, as well as Ginger Vitus for Philadelphia.
Busick comes back in. Tarantula takes her to the outside, going to recycle her as far back as possible. V Diva, meanwhile, struggling on the outside, gets around Quigley and is now eligible to score. So Busick through for five, going to call it off.
We're going to start the jam 3-2, favoring the Mile High Club. Score is Denver 116, Philadelphia 51. 5 minutes, 25 seconds left in this first half. Looks like Dizellum on the line for Denver, number 36, up against number 7 for Philadelphia, Clam Jammer.
Just two blockers for Dizellum to beat. Four Clam Jammer. Both jammers having a struggle getting out there. High block called on Tarantula. Dizellum able to escape the pack. Lead jammer. And a back block call on Clam Jammer. It's a power jam for Denver.
Nice work there by Dizellum. Feints to the outside. Takes the inside line. 5 points on the board for Denver. Philadelphia now backing up at the rear of the pack. Akers looking for some offense. And now Salvador up at the front.
DeZellum just 2-2. Gets a little swallowed back up, and there's a stumble in the pack. A whistle blows.
Looks like Russian Bayou to the box for Philadelphia.
DeZellum taking to the infield by Teflon Donna. Got a call off the jam just as Clam Jammer returns from the penalty box.
All right, 4 minutes left in this period. Denver 125, Philly 51. Philly's been stuck in that area for a little bit, looking to get their jammers out on the next one, hoping to pull some penalties on Denver. And looks like a timeout is called now by Philadelphia. So again, second day of the Big O. If you want to see the scores and recaps, you can check out all of that on ecrd.org?
I'm going to bet it's .org.
But anyway, look up Emerald City Rollerballs, and you can go to the Big O tab, and you'll see the scores from the game. We've had amazing derby here. We have women's, we have juniors, we have men's. It's been a pretty fantastic tournament thus far, and Eugene and ECRD has been great hosts.
Absolutely agree. I'm ready to move here.
Oh, it's very nice. I really like it.
I'm right there with you.
All right, number 15, Kill Martin jamming for Philadelphia against number 20, Wilhelm for Denver. 4-3 pack favoring the Mile High Club.
There's the whistle. Wilhelm getting a little bit of speed behind her as she gets off the line there. Looking to break right through, and one to go. She beats it. Out lead jammer for Denver.
Good defense here by Denver as Long recycles to the front. Quigley now and Long preventing a bridge. Multiplayer block called on Angeli. She'll head to the box.
Wilhelm, meanwhile, coming through along the inside line, takes a hit but stays in. 4 points, calls off the jam, holding Philly to zero.
Once again, Denver brings their score up to 129, Philadelphia 51, 3 minutes and 15 seconds left in this first period of play. So this wonderful stream has been brought to you by WFTD.TV as well as Blaze Streaming Media. They've always done a great job with all their streams thus far here within Roller Derby.
Number 4, Busick, taking on number 152, Herman Monster, as we get into the next jam. And Busick up front getting a forearm call. So power jam for Philly. Herman Monster coming through a direction of play penalty on number 957 for Philly. That's Gingivitis and a high
and a
block.
High block. Yeah, number 80, Papa Roach for Philadelphia.
So hemorrhage and blockers from Philly as Herman Monster out lead and a forearm call on Dalgallo.
That's Akers.
Oh, I'm sorry, that is Akers.
Bridge now by Angeli as Salvador and Lester work on Herman Monster at the front. Philadelphia now rejoined by Gingivitis. Pack is still small and through, 5 points on the board for Philadelphia.
Busick now returning from the penalty box and right into a wall of white. Taking some hits from number 957, Gingivitis in the pack. And Busick finds her way out, and Herman Monster into the pack, calls off the jam, picks up all four for Philly.
Denver's still at 129. Philly now at 60, 1 minute and 30 seconds left in this first period. We've had a lot of roller derby today. Coming up at 5 p.m., Puget Sound versus Bridgetown, MRDA, high-level MRDR bout. MRDA about coming up, and then Helsinki versus Northwest Arkansas.
Already an up to jam this time for the Mile High Club. It's number 719, Sharpless. And number 7, Clam Jammer for Philly.
Good work by both defenses. Containment at the front by Philly. And at the rear by Denver. And it looks like a cut track penalty now on Sharpless. Lead jammer called for Clam Jammer, Philadelphia. 4-on-3 favoring Philly.
Already, it looks like not lead jammer. The jam ref, the jam refs had a discussion and they changed it, so she's not lead jammer, but is unopposed. So, good opportunity for Philly to make up some points here.
Right, so we'll go about a minute longer than the period clock here with this jam. Good blocking up front by Denver, pushed out by Quigley, and she picks up a penalty as Sharpless comes around the outside to return back to play.
And Clam Jammer coming up against that mile high wall again is driven to the outside. Once again, going to be recycled all the way back as Sharpless picks up a cutting the track penalty, hit off to the outside, and then step back in just a little too soon.
Good offense there up front now. Clam Jammer, she beats Salvador, and she's through 5 more points on the board for Philadelphia. Time has expired in the period, but still about 25 seconds left in this jam. Teflon Donna playing some O as S.H. Long knocks out Clam Jammer to the inside.
Clam Jammer getting stuck right there behind Barrett and S.H. Long.
Salvador now bridging for the Mile High Club back to the Philly pack. And that is the end of the jam. 5 more points on the board for Philadelphia. That'll take their score to 70. Denver 129. Smash, your assessment thus far.
Some intense gameplay. The jammer penalties have really helped out both teams in this bout. I think coming back, Philly's going to need to watch their jammer penalties and maybe bring a little more O into that MHC wall if they want to increase their score. That MHC wall has given them some trouble.
I totally agree. And for Denver to continue winning this game, they've got to keep their players on the track. It's been shown thus far when there are at least 4 of them on the track, it's super tough for Philly to get through. But they've been hemorrhaging blockers at a sort of a crazy rate, wherein they've had packs of 2 on a regular basis, packs of 3 on a regular basis. And for sure, their jammers are having some difficulty without an extra push in that offense that they need.
Yeah, and that's a great assessment. I completely agree with you.
All right, we got about 9 minutes before we turn back to action. I am Joe Mama.
I'm Bangers and Smash.
We will see you shortly. And we are back. Welcome to the second half. Philly Roller Derby Liberty Bells versus Denver Roller Derby's Mile High Club. Interestingly enough, both teams rebranded this year to be more inclusive, as both their statements have done so. It used to be Philly Roller Girls, changed their name to Philly Roller Derby. It used to be Denver Roller Dolls, also changed their name to Denver Roller Derby. Kind of reflects a nice little change in the inclusiveness of the derby community. Jamming now for Philly Roller Derby, Kill Martin up against number 4, Busick for Denver. Scores Denver 129, Philly 70. Philly in the white, Denver in the navy blue.
Already Busick already recycled back behind the entire pack. And Kill Martin at the front side of the pack there up against Delgado and Salvador as the pack starts to stretch out.
Nice bridging there by Akers and Lester. Delgado, last one to beat, and Kill Martin through lead jammer Philadelphia. And looks like a multiplayer block called on Tarantula number 401. Kill Martin now putting points on the board for Philly.
Busick has made it out and is looking to hit the back of the pack there, but Kill Martin goes and shuts down the jam. 2 points on the board for Philly.
Denver 129, Philadelphia 72, 29 minutes and 8 seconds left. Want to thank Hot Mama's Wings. Hey, I know maybe you're watching this on the stream. Maybe you're taking a break from the derby action, but you're watching it on the stream. Hey, if you come in with a Big O bracelet, you'll receive a discount Saturday night. They'll be open until 12 a.m., located at 420 West 13th Avenue, 10 minutes from the Lane Event Center.
Number 20, Wilhelm jamming 4, Denver. Number 152, Herman Monster 4, Philly. Wilhelm at the front there, makes it past, and his lead jammer, Teflon Donna, tried to stop her. It just didn't happen. Quigley headed to the penalty box. 4 Mile High Club puts Mile High Club down 1 blocker.
Herman Monster now tough, and she is through for Philadelphia. Wilhelm stays on her feet now, one to beat. That's Teflon Donna up front, and she is through, calls the jam, picking up the full 4 points for the Mile High Club. Denver takes their score to 134, Philadelphia 72, 28 minutes and 5 seconds left in this second period of play. So again, we're gonna have to see Philly step it up a little bit in terms of their defense. It is Lorich jamming for the first time this game up against number 9. Deb Seriously also jamming for the first time this game. Hey, why not do it all at the same time?
As it Lorich takes Deb Seriously off to the outfield, but Deb Seriously able to come back on pretty quick.
And that now name is kind of amazing for announcing. Lorich now fighting up against a wall of gingivitis and now facing off against V Diva, but called lead jammer. And Deb Seriously is stuck in the pack behind Dow Gallo, Akers, and Lester.
Lorich coming back in for a scoring pass now on the outside line. Both jammers jammed up in the pack. Lorich going into the infield. I see a helmet cover being removed.
It looks like 9:57 to the box. That's gingivitis for Philadelphia. Helmet cover has been removed, but Denver doing a good job of keeping V Diva away from Deb Seriously. And Lorch now recycled all the way back at turn three.
Now V Diva has the star, puts it on, and is being recycled behind Akers and Salvador. Lorch picks up 5 points on the pass and makes her way out and going back in for more.
4-3 pack favoring the Mile High Club. Lorch slides to the inside of turn four, has to recycle in behind Papa Roach.
V Diva also taken out by Quigley and recycled all the way back by Akers. And there's Lorch, nice little spin around, see where things are at. She's got 5 more points for the Mile High Club.
And now Quigley getting in the recycling game. Colorado, environmentally friendly, recycling jammers daily. And Lorch now with one to beat, and she is through. That'll be another 5 points on the board for Denver.
V Diva getting some help from her team members there, and Salvador looking to hold her up, but she is out now, eligible to score. That was her initial pass. Lorch coming back into the pack for score, calls off the jam. 0 points for Philly. Let's see how many Lorch got on the last air. 2 points for Denver.
Big jam by Lorch takes the score for Denver. 150, Philadelphia 72, 25 minutes and 30 seconds left in this game. Jamming now for the Mile High Club. That is number 4, Busick, up and over against number 7 for Philadelphia. Clam jammer, 4 on the floor in the pack. Jammer's now jostling position at the pivot line. Busick looking to the outside. Clam jammer looking to the inside. Now changing their tack to the middle. Both walls exceptionally good for both teams.
Nice slow pack as they come around and almost making it a turn two. Clam jammer coming around the outside is going to pick up a cut as she thought she was safe. She stood up thinking she was going to get that lead call, but she is. It looks like she got the lead call, yes.
But then she tapped her foot out of line. So her hips passed the last blocker. But unfortunately, her inside skate tapped the inside of the line. So she got the cut when she stood up to establish her position in front of the other skaters that she cut. Erstwhile, Busick putting 5 points on the board for Denver. Denver now playing some offense at the front. And a penalty now assessed to Barrett.
Busick back in, meets that wall of white, starts to break it apart. Some nice hits from Busick on the wall there.
And now Teflon. Penalty number 85, Teflon Donna to the box. 5 more points on the board for Busick. Jammer now in for Philadelphia. Clam jammer speeds around, unimpeded on the inside. Now can put points on the board. And
Busick picking up a forearm as she came into the pack there. She's going to the penalty box. That allows Clam Jammer to get through for 5 as there was a little bit of confusion about who the penalty was on. Now Clam Jammer all the way around looking to put even more points on the board for Philly.
Pack is at the rear with Barrett. And looks like a penalty now. Track cut pulled by Denver on Clam Jammer. Everyone's skating in the clockwise direction now as Busick will be released for Denver. Philadelphia recycling her to the back of the pack. And Busick picks up 4 points quickly there as 2:47 Devoid of Mercy heads to the box for Philadelphia. Two more points on that pass for Philadelphia. Score stands now. Philly 74, Denver 170, 23 minutes left in this game.
And Denver's going to start the next jam with a power jam. Most of that penalty still existing for Philly's jammer. That's going to be number 20, Wilhelm, looking to take this power jam for Denver.
And everyone on the pivot line. What's that? It's like a unicorn. Wilhelm through now, looking for some offense. That's Akers. One to beat up front, and she's through. Lead jammer, Wilhelm. Denver with a full complement of blockers on the track. Philly with one in the box, and their jammer in the box, who is now standing. Less than 10 seconds left for her then. Akers now playing some offense, and Wilhelm throwing the inside.
Nice little hop, skip, and a jump there. Clam jammer returns from the penalty box, comes up into the back of the pack. Akers waiting for forearm on Tarantula. Wilhelm also back into the pack, is getting recycled.
And looks like pack destruction penalty called now, and number 99 for Philadelphia. Russian Bayou will head to the box as Wilhelm calls the jam. See how many more points she picked up. 4 full points on the board for her. Russian Bayou unfortunately split the pack up by backing up more than 10 feet, causing the no pack to happen. All right, DeZellum now jamming for the Mile High Club, number 36. Kilmartin for Philly, number 15.
174-79.
Philly now with only 2 blockers on the track. Denver with all their personnel on board. DeZellum threw on the outside. Lead jammer, Denver.
Kilmartin already hit to the outside once and now stuck in the wall of Denver blockers.
DeZellum now already on a scoring pass. Teflon, Donna, and Merle Stripper to beat. And forearm penalty now called on Teflon, Donna. All the points, all the time for DeZellum.
Only 1 blocker left on the track. Merle Stripper for Philly at the front. 2 at the back, though, waiting for DeZellum as she comes back. It's Tarantula and Russian Bayou.
Good work by Philly, catching her at the rear of the pack. Unlike trout season, no releasing, but DeZellum has to release on her own, and she's through. Another 5 points on the board for Denver.
Kilmartin still struggling with that wall of blue in the pack at the front. I guess navy would be a better call for
indigo, that color. What do you want to call it? Roy G. Biv.
Dark blue. DeZellum now on the outside line, hit after hit from Russian Bayou. Finally, Russian Bayou knocking her to the outside. She's going to be recycling.
Now Meryl Stripper with the star for Philadelphia, dealing with a wall of Garten, Long, and Quigley. Quigley now bridging at the rear. Good work up front by the Denver blockers. Now Barrett bridging. And a cut track penalty on DeZellum. We're going to finish this jam. 15 seconds left.
That is going to be a power jam for Philly.
Meryl Stripper finds her way out. Now eligible to score. This is the that was the initial pass for Philly as the jam comes to an end.
Maybe I'm confused as an announcer. If the pivot cap falls off before you put it on, can you put the star on?
It looks like it was eligible.
Maybe the Twitterverse can help me. Come at me. Come at me, bro. I'm at Joe Mama Derby on the tweets. I don't have my WFTDA rulebook in front of me. All right, now Philly out there unopposed on the jam line. Number 152, Herman Monster. Penalty now assessed to Salvador. Lead jammer, Philadelphia.
Herman Monster coming around looking for points. Signals for some O. Gets it from Teflon Donna, but then gets hung up by the Mile High wall. Has to recycle and start that push through again. Dalgallo, Akers, and Lester in that wall, doing a really good job holding onto the jammer as DeZellum returns from the penalty box and meets a wall of three from Philly at the back.
Good work there up front by Teflon Donna to brace. And looks like a multiplayer block now will be assessed at 247, devoid of mercy for Philadelphia. Just one to beat up front, that's Akers, and she has to let her go. 5 points on the board for Herman Monster.
DeZella, meanwhile, finds a way on the inside line. She sees that hole open up. She takes it right away out of the pack, eligible to score. Herman Monster coming in. Dalgallo looking to stop her, taking her to the outfield. She calls the jam with 3 points on the board for Philly.
Dalgallo gets her out, but catches a forearm penalty on the way. She'll head to the box for Denver. That'll leave them one short in the pack. Sharpless now on the jam line for the Mile High Club. Number 7, Clam Jammer for Philadelphia. Denver at the front, Philadelphia at the rear. One blocker apiece in the box, but the pivot for Philadelphia now standing.
The Clam Jammers tried to get through that front wall twice, and S.H. Long and Quigley were there to take care of her and show her where the outside was. Sharpless at the back, not having any more luck against Philly's wall either.
Philly doing a great job at the rear of the pack, constantly recycling Sharpless. Quigley trying to mix it up and play some O on for Sharpless. Clamjammer still not out. And it looks like a forearm penalty now called on S.H. Long for Denver. Dalgallo out and Long in. And a back block penalty now assessed to the jammer from Philadelphia. Clamjammer in the box, power jam for Sharpless, but she is still not out of the pack. We are 1 minute into the jam. We have no lead jammer.
Now Sharpless just being recycled. It means she's going to have to start that long journey through this tough pack again. She's able to get some offensive help from the Mile High blockers that are still out there because she is unopposed, but it is just a tough, tough pack.
Philadelphia doing a great job with their recycling and their walls. 1 minute and 25 seconds in, no lead jammer, and Philadelphia's jammer back in the fray. Clam jammer working hard. Good work by Barrett on the outside, then excellent recycling by Russian Bayou for Philadelphia. Tarantula bridging now to the back with Gingivitis, or sorry, Devoid of Mercy. Misconduct called now on number 957, Gingivitis. She knocked down Quigley. Still, we have 5 seconds left in this jam. No lead jammer.
No purchase at all for anybody. Lots of penalties happen in there. Multiplayer right there at the end on 401 Tarantula for Philly. That's going to start Philly down two blockers in the next jam. But, whoa, you don't often see two-minute no jammers out of the pack.
That's all defense right there. Excellent defense by both squads. An excellent penalty kill by Philadelphia to maintain keeping Sharpless in play during that entire minute where Denver had a full complement of blockers to play offense. Jamming now for Philly. That is number 15, Kilmartin, up against number 19, 11, Lorch for Denver.
And Lorch, holy moly, the whistle blows. She sees that outside inside line open, takes it, lead jammer, Denver. Kilmartin looks to go to the outside, but Akers with a nice spin move takes her out to the outfield. She's going to recycle as Lorch in and through, going to pick up all 5 points for Denver.
Nice work there by Lester with a shoulder block in the reverse position. Lorch now coming up on the pack one more time for scoring points, and she is through, but Teflon Donna making life difficult for her at the front. Tarantula now to mix it up at the back of the pack with the Denver blockers. Lorch getting recycled at turn three. Good offense there by Salvador. Frees Lorch, 5 points on the board for Denver.
Still stuck at the back. Kilmartin looking to make some headway is taken out and then recycled, and now she's looking to pass off the helmet cover.
Looks like Devoid of Mercy has it now, and all of Denver is focused on her. One to beat up front, that's Lester, and she is through, but picks up a forearm penalty for Philadelphia. Power jam as Lorch goes through with five more points for Denver. Devoid of mercy, pivot come jammer. She will be the jammer. So power jam Denver.
And Denver gonna field number four, Busick, for the power jam.
Denver score stands 204, Philadelphia 87. If you're tuning in on WFTDA.tv, Denver in the blue, Philadelphia in the white. 12 minutes and 50 seconds left in this game. Power jam Denver, a little bit of offense from the rear of the pack. Busick's trying to find a seam. And a multiplayer block called on, that is Russian, Papa Roach.
And Busick finds her way out with that penalty. Lead jammer goes to Denver. Now Busick on a scoring pass, just three to beat in the pack. She goes toward the outside and then right down the middle, but picks up a back block call. She's going to go sit for 30 seconds as we get Devoid of Mercy back on the track. Her penalty was already done before Busick sat.
Devoid of Mercy with a nice jump to the inside. Initial pass complete. Scoring pass initiated.
Coming in looking for some points. Hits a wall made up of S.H. Long and Barrett right there. Holding her up and now Quigley getting in on the action on the outside line.
Papa Roach back to the mix for Philadelphia as Busick is released as well. So wall of Philly at the rear, wall of Denver at the front as Barrett takes a penalty for the Mile High Club.
And Busick back in, solid wall of white waiting for her at the back. Devoid of Mercy through for five, and there's Busick through for five as well.
Denver now looking to make some headway. Quigley recycled, has to join the pack at the rear as Busick comes through on a scoring pass, but Devoid of Mercy, 4 points picked up quickly. Busick stuck behind that very tough wall of white. Gingivitis with some big moves at the back of the pack.
Devoid of Mercy coming back in again. Quigley looking to hold her up.
And Devoid of Mercy picking up a back block penalty. Power jam reversal. 5 seconds left in the jam. Four more points there for the Mile High Club. Devoid of Mercy back to the box for Philadelphia. Denver will have a power jam start. Denver takes the score 2-13. Philadelphia 96. 10 minutes and 40 seconds left in this game.
So we saw something like this happen earlier, Joe, where we had the helmet cover pass to a pivot who's not normally a jammer.
Right.
They got a penalty. They sat over a jam and then they sat over a second jam. This is where Denver was able to get some good momentum, good pull between the two teams and hasn't lost it since. So here's another chance for Denver to stretch that out even further.
Yes, sir. But Devoid of Mercy quite successful with the jamming. Maris Schipper had a little bit more issue with the Denver blockers, but Devoid, had it not been for that cut penalty, as was very successful in her jamming. Now, Wilhelm out by her lonesome. Lead jammer Denver. Four skaters from both squads on the track. Wilhelm hits that wall. Devoid of Mercy standing up in the box.
Wilhelm taking to the outside, picking up a low block call. She's going to the penalty box as Devoid of Mercy hitting the pack, looking for her initial pass. Denver turns on the defense.
And a star pass by Devoid of Mercy. Looks like that's to number 152, Herman Monster, the pivot. Smart play by Philly, putting one of your primary jammers in as your pivot. Out of play, and DeGallo has to let her go. We're going to go to full 2 minutes with 50 seconds left in this jam.
Wilhelm up from the box as Herman Monster coming back in for a scoring pass. Gets hung up there by the blockers from the Mile High Club.
Good work there from Herman Monster. Threw on the outside. 5 points on the board for Philadelphia. And whistles blow as we have a penalty assessed to a Philadelphia blocker. Wilhelm through, making a move on the outside. Runs into Devoid of Mercy and picks up a high block penalty. Devoid of Mercy to the box. 5 points on the board for Wilhelm. Herman Monster now stuck behind Lester at the back of the pack. Wilhelm looking for some daylight on the outside. Doesn't find any. Some offense on the inside by Salvador. And now dealing with Teflon Donna and Legend of the Hit and Trample.
Wilhelm all the way through for 5 points. Jam comes to an end. 3 more points on the board for Philly as the jam comes to an end. That's going to take us to 223-104. 8 minutes remaining on the clock. An official timeout. Looks like just double checking the penalty board. Making sure everybody served the time they got to serve in prison.
All right, looks like we're about to start off. We've got number 36, DeZellum, up against number 15, Kilmartin. Four two-pack favoring the Mile High Club. One blocker in the box for Philly standing. Ooh, some recycling now by Kilmartin, pushing DeZellum out. And so she has entered behind. A little pause for effect.
And it looked like Kilmartin using that tactic to maybe get another blocker back on the track from the penalty box. She saw one standing. That worked in her advantage. The blocker came back, but DeZellum still able to steal that lead jammer status.
Oh, nice work by Kilmartin. Finally opening and quickly accelerated through, out for Philly eligible to score. But DeZellum through, points on the board, does not call the jam, keeping Kilmartin out on the track. S.L.A. Chong recycles her to the outside. And DeZellum finds a nice seam on the inside through. 5 points on the board for Denver. Kilmartin runs into the back of S.H. Chong.
Good call by the bench, not signaling for DeZellum to call it off. She's able to continue racking up points, and the blockers from Denver are able to keep holding. Looks like Quigley off to the penalty box for a forearm call as DeZellum threw for another 5 points on the board. And Kilmartin still taking a beating in the pack. And there she goes. She's finally out past Angeli for four.
Good work by Philadelphia now. But DeZellum still on the track, still putting points on the board. Up against Michelle Castro. Calls the jam off. 3 points more on the board for Denver. No points on that last pass for Philly. That'll take the score to Denver 240. Philadelphia 108. 6 minutes and 15 seconds left in this game. So suffice it to say, I think, Smash, that Denver's got this game in hand. What do you think they are going to be focused on for the next few jams? They have a tough game tomorrow in Victorian.
They do have a tough game tomorrow, but again, you got to remember that rankings are based on point spreads as well. So Denver's not going to be wanting to give up any more points to Philly, and they're still going to be looking to put points on the board.
And I think conversely, Philly, they're looking at a tough Bay Area opponent who fell to Victorian today. They will play them tomorrow at 3:30 p.m. here after the Victoria versus Denver game. So Lorch is out. Seitz is out. Seitz puts points on the board for Philadelphia. Lorch runs into the back of number 99. Russian Bayou has to recycle in back behind as Seitz putting points on the board for Philly. Just three blockers out there for Philly, doing a great job of holding Lorch back.
Salvador knocking V Diva off the track, recycling her as far back as possible. Number 33, Legend of the Hit and Trample, is gone to the penalty box for multiplayer. That puts Philly down a blocker on the track. Lorch also just recycled. Neither jammer getting a whole lot of headway as they get toward the front of the pack. They get taken out.
Looks like Denver may be going for a points for points strategy here to wear down the opponent. Quigley now to the box for Denver. Lorch now looking for some offense from Salvador. Oh, and Salvador takes down V Diva.
Big falls in the pack there as we recover, though. Lorch up and out. 5 more points on the pack. And low block called on V Diva from that big fall. That means she's off to the penalty box. It's a power jam for Denver.
That was a big hit by Salvador. Right in the derby spot. So totally legit. V Diva just kind of went down a little bit awkwardly. and then caused Lorch to trip on her. Good offense there by Salvador.
Lorch on the outside gets a no pass, no penalty, and already picked up the point, 5 points on the pass. She's all the way through. We'll start the next jam with a power jam.
Looks like Philly's going to call a timeout here. Denver 250, Philly 113. 3 minutes and 43 seconds left. Again, I think you have to think about the jammers and the blockers that you have that maybe haven't getting enough play time in this game. So maybe you start putting them out. So regardless of the score, you know the outcome is certain. Denver 250 right now, Philly 117. Give some of the other skaters an opportunity. Maybe they can focus on what they need to do tomorrow against the respective teams they're playing. Philly will face Barry at 3:30 here on track one. Denver faces Victorian at 1:30 here on track one. So again, we got to see both of those teams face off against each other. Tough slog for both squads, but Victorian out on top. Team making a travel here all the way from Melbourne, Australia. So I anticipate a lot of good roller derby tomorrow between the four teams, Victorian, Denver, Bay Area, Philadelphia.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And I agree, you're right. Make some changes up, take a look and see. Maybe you'll find another superstar hidden on the bench somewhere. And give a rest to those who you depend on a lot so that they can conserve for tomorrow's very challenging games that are going to be coming up.
Yeah, but agreed, you know, the way that the points and the rankings are determined, point spreads do make a difference. So Philadelphia wanting to make up some ground here, Denver wanting to stretch it out as much as they can. So we'll see what sort of strategy they go with. Looks like they've got Garten out there, again, a up-and-coming mile-high club skater who mostly skates on the Denver B team, getting double repped here today with the mile-high club. Sharpless now jamming out there by her lonesome. 3-0 up front. Nice work there by Philadelphia.
And Sharpless finds her way clear before Clam Jammer is released. So lead jammer goes to Denver. And Clam Jammer just now coming in and getting stuck in the MHC wall as Sharpless back around for a scoring pass.
Nice recycling by SH Lama. Clam Jammer too agile on the outside. Makes a move and is out. Sharpless stuck in the pack. Calls off the jam.
Holds Philly to zero. Picks up 3 points for herself. So increases that lead that Denver's got by just a few points.
All right. Denver 253. Philly 117. 2 minutes and 40 seconds left. Jamming for Philadelphia, number 15, Kill Martin, up against number 4 for Denver, Busick.
And we've seen a lot of jams where the penalty box has been empty, and here's another one for you. All five on the track as we get started.
Kill Martin, wall of blue at the rear. Busick, wall of white at the front, but Angeli trying to mix things up, playing a little offense there on Tarantula. And Busick finds the outside through lead jammer, Denver.
Kilmartin still fighting at the back there, not finding a whole lot of purchase pass. It's going to toss the helmet cover to number 9, Deb Seriously. But Denver is just ready for that to happen and is trapping Deb just as hard.
Yeah, good work there by Philadelphia to pass that star as Deb Seriously takes the helmet cover and is now eligible to score as Busick calls the jam. 1 point there for Busick on that second pass as we come to a score of Denver 254, Philadelphia 117, 1 minute and 23 seconds left in this game.
So from what I'm seeing, it looks like Denver not looking to put a whole lot of points on the board. They're looking to make sure that they don't give up anything, though.
Yes.
So Busick was taking her time there in that last one. She wasn't terribly concerned about getting all 4 points. She just wanted to make sure that she stayed clean and didn't take any penalties as she went through that pack.
That is correct. And Wilhelm jamming now for Denver up against Herman Monster for Philadelphia. Herman Monster now facing off up at the Denver wall at the front. Wilhelm facing off a very nice centipede of Philly blockers at the rear of the pack. Teflon Donna anchoring at the front and through, but not lead, Herman Monster. Looks like a no pass, no penalty. And Wilhelm could possibly pick up lead here, and she does, choosing not to call off the jam. Looks like the signal was given up the front by Scott Free to continue going. Dow Gallo headed in the box for Denver. 5 points on the, sorry, 4 points on the board there for Herman Monster.
And Wilhelm back in for a scoring pass of her own. Nice little hop around the outside line there. She's going to put up 4 points for Denver. Time ticking down. I think that we're just looking at, let's get the time off the clock.
Yeah, Wilhelm stopped at the back of the pack at turn four. Herman Monster looking for some more room, recycled by Barrett. And Wilhelm waits for the period clock to end, calls the jam. That'll take the unofficial score. Denver 258, Philadelphia 124, doubling up. Just a little bit more doubling up on Philadelphia today. Smash, what you got for me, assessment-wise? These two teams, we have a big tournament. You know, we had a tournament, the Spudtown Throwdown, happened a few weekends ago. We have the big, we've got other tournaments, ECDX coming up. What are these teams focusing on here at the beginning of the season?
Denver's roster changed a bit over the years, so they're finding their how these walls are working together. You see some changing up happening here and there. You see some different strategies coming out of the Mile High Club. A little more while doing some really heavy blocking. Not something you're typically seeing from Denver in previous seasons. So a little bit of change up there. Same thing, Philly changing up their roster a bit. You're seeing some people who weren't jamming as much coming back into jamming, and some really good tight walls from Philly as well.
Yeah, and you're seeing an evolution of walls into a more triangle or diamond-shaped formations. Seeing a lot of strong anchoring and backwards skating. Again, I think at the beginning of the season, you're trying to figure out your lines, see who the up-and-coming skaters are. You never know who you're going to get come tournament season. Injuries happen, transfers happen, life happens.
Yeah.
So the score today, not necessarily indicative of what will happen in the future come tournament season, but I think this is a good indicator. And also given the history between Philadelphia and Denver, Denver showing their dominance over Philadelphia once more. Again, Philly was really close at champs last year, but Denver here, too much for them today. Denver score of 258, Philadelphia 124. That was a great game. I think both teams showed their mettle, and Philly's got a bunch to work on. Obviously, Denver has a bunch to work on, but beginning of the season, let's get the jitters out and move forward. All right, thank you for tuning in to WFTDA.tv. Stay tuned on this very track. Puget Sound versus Bridgetown. High-level MRDA play. Thank you for tuning in. I am Joe Mama.
I'm Bangers and Smash.
You guys have yourselves a fantastic Saturday.